So good morning everyone. So this video we are going to discuss about orthographic projections. So already we know that orthographic projections it is converting the 3D view into the 2D view. Okay, so isometric view they are given, that we have to convert into the front view, top view and side views. Okay, what are the required views they are asking, that we have to convert it. Okay, so usually you are going to convert front, top and side view. Already we people know that there are four quadrants are there. So in that four quadrant drawings, second and the fourth quadrant drawings, they were never used anywhere else because of the second quadrant drawing, in that while rotating the horizontal plane towards to the picture plane, so both the front view and top view, it will be placed on the same profile plane, so we could not get view, so that nowhere else they use the second quadrant drawing. Same like in the fourth quadrant drawings also, while rotating this, it will be goes and placed on the horizontal plane, rotating towards to the fourth quadrant, vertical plane, that is the profile of a picture plane. So both the views, it will be merged to front view and top view, so that we could not get it view clearly, so that in anywhere else we are not using the fourth quadrant diagrams also. So now we are using first and third quadrant drawings. So here the first quadrant diagram there will be shown, so the user will be here. So once the projection, it will be placed on the vertical plane, and the top view projection, it will be placed on the horizontal plane. So once while rotating this one towards to the clockwise direction, horizontal plane, it will be goes to the vertical direction, as well as the top view, it will becomes below the front view. Same like side view, now right side view placed on the left side, so it will be comes into the left of the front view. So right side view, it comes into the left of the front view. Same like left side view, it will be placed on the right side plane, so it will comes right of the front view. So like that it will be placed. So say but in the coming into the this one coming into the third quadrant drawings, front view it comes over there and top view it goes into the up. So usually in the third angle projection only they can use the experts. So for beginners and learners, we are going to discuss only about the first angle projections. Okay, then we can go and see some of the example for the orthographic drawings. So here the 3D drawing they given. So here the front, it will be look like a square. So here also they will be shown as a square. So in this one front view, only the edges, side edges we can see, so that's what they are drawn. But this cut out, this edge we could not able to view over here from the front view, so that will be comes behind the front view, so that we have to make it as in the dotted line. So which are all the parts or edges or corners, so those things it comes invisible in the drawings, that you can make it as a dotted line over here. So that's what it comes as a dotted line. Even in the here the front view, even in the top view, while seeing the from the top view, we can see this square over here, that is the thing we have drawn over here. And also this cutout we could not see, so that is it comes over here, that edge will come over here in the dotted line. And will come see from the side view, see over here in the side view, that means it is the right side view, but they are given here as a left side view, so that left side view comes in the right side of the front view. So there also small the cutout it can visible, so there we could not see any other or invisible edges, so that all the line it will becomes as a continuous line only. So once if we take down the orthographic views, always in the first quadrant front view it comes for top, below the front view top view is coming over here, and the sides of front views, the right side view and left side view it will place. And also one more point we have to remember over here, so this edge it will not cross the this edge, same like here also. So it will not extend over here, same like here also. And while creating the 45 degree line over here, this edge, it will be equal to the this edge. Okay, so it should be not more than this edge. So like that, the relationship, it has to be maintained in the orthographic views. Then coming to the sectional orthographic views. So what is the section means? So to view the inside part, they are going to make the section, sectional view. So here the section plane, it will be passing over mid of the component. Why? Because of these holes and all, while seeing from here, we could not able to see the diameter and other things. So for that purpose, they are making as a section. Okay, so once if we cut it over here, see over exactly in the middle here, there is a material, so that they are making as a section lines or hatching lines. And here it is a hollow in portion, so here we know it does not have any material, so that it is the like only the edges only they are going to mention over here. So here it has a material, so that they are going to make the hatching line over here. While section plane passes of the component, it will be indicate wherever the material is there only it will indicate the hatching. So exactly it will be passing over there, any hole or any cutout is there, it will be showing only the edges of the hole as well as the cutout. Even here also only the edges. Okay, see over here like this, it will be shows. Okay, so this is about the orthographic sectional view. And also one more point we have to remember, if the section plane is either it may be vertical or horizontal, any one view only we are getting as a sectional view. Suppose the sectional plane is a inclined one, two views we are getting as a sectional view, either it may be a top and the side view, or front and top view, or top front and side views. So like this, any two views, it going to be visible for the this one inclined cutting plane or sectional plane, it will passes. Then coming to here, we will see the exercise over here. So how to make the orthographic views over in the drawings. Okay, so in this one we are going trying to draw in the SolidWorks software. Go over here, select drawing. So always we are going to start with drawing. For drawing, first we are going to set the sheet setup. So A4 size sheets, and click on the show background off, so it has to remove. So give OK, and going to give fit, and select line. And after selecting the line, so here the thing is, wherever the arrow mark it indicates, there only the front view. Okay, suppose that they are providing some three arrow marks, means that definitely they are going to mention front view, top view, and side view, or FVTV as well as SV. So like this they are going to mention, or otherwise simply only one arrow mark given, that we can consider as a front view. So in this front view, while seeing from towards from here, so what are all the things we can see, means this is the L shape we can see, as well as this inclined one we could be able to see. Okay, so this inclined one, while projecting towards the picture plane or vertical plane, so what happens, this edges it comes as a straight over there. Okay, and also this triangle part we can see over here in the, while seeing from the front view. Okay, so these are all the visible edges we will see, but the thing is this dovetail cut out we couldn't able to see over from the front view, so that should be drawn in the dotted line. So here on the bottom, on small bottom it having the edges, and then the top also edges is coming over there. So once in this thing, if you see from here, this edge it will be aided by the continuous line. So the bottom line you need not to worry about it, because that dotted line it will be aided by the continuous line. So okay, so from here these lines only you can able to see over there. Okay, so how to draw those this orthographic projection? Go to line from we are going to start from the horizontal line. So horizontal line, what is the length over here? They are given, so from 100 mm, so I'm going to draw a 100 mm length and height. So height is there, so from here 22 mm they provided over here, so that 22 mm I'm going to make it as here. So 22 mm and towards left, from here to towards left how much mm it has to go? So they are not given, so this value they are given, we can check over here, that is the 15 mm distance. So from here to 100 minus 15 we are getting as a 85 mm line. So 85, enter. And what is the height? So height is there, so from here to that is what is the height? So from bottom to top is 75 mm, bottom to top is 75 mm, but from this inclined line dimension is 16 mm. Okay, so those inclined line dimension is 16 mm, so 75 minus already 75 minus from here to 75 minus 22 we are getting as a, because this line we have to subtract, so 75 minus 22, so we are getting as a 53 mm, and coming over here, so it is the 15 mm distance, and I'm going to join over here before. Okay, then after joining this, again I'm going to select a line. We will see from the top to what is that 16 mm distance, one more edge you can see, that inclined surface edge we can see over here. The top we have drawn over here. Okay, already I told you, while projecting this towards to the vertical plane, the inclined surfaces it comes as a straight. Okay, select a line from here to, we are going to make it as a 16 mm line. I'm going to join over here. Okay, after joined, then comes to here. So the height, so this triangle we can go and draw. So for this I'm going to start with the C. From here to this end the dimension is 70 mm, from here to height is 40 mm. So go over here, select a line from this end to 40 mm distance, then I'm going to make it here as a 70 mm distance, 70 mm. I'm going to join over the particular line, 40 mm line edge. Okay, so after drawn this almost in the front view, the visible portions, all the things we have drawn, the only thing is the remaining thing is the that invisible line. So invisible line from bottom to what is the distance over here? That is the 12 mm height. So from here to this one 12 mm height, I'm going to draw a line, and from there to I'm going to make a straight line. After that going to select as a this one, select as a dotted line over here. So even you can try it here, one more line you can draw, make it that line as a dotted line, even that time only the continuous line you can see over there. So in this drawing, so why we are taking this one as a full depth means throughout the component means, otherwise if it will be stop over anywhere in the middle means they will be going to mentioned over here. Suppose it's not mentioned means we are going to take it as a full deep, it has to be go over the dovetail cutoff throughout the component. Okay, so then we are going to draw the top view. Well, before going to draw the top view, what are all the surfaces you can see? So this incline, while seeing from the top, so this inclined one you can see here, the other side inclined one, and these are all the area we can see, and also top of the rib. In the top of the rib you will see, so that these are all the things you can see. So this rectangle and these are all the inclined surfaces, straight and again inclined surfaces. So these are all the things we will see. But which are all the things you could not able to see? This dovetail cutout. In the dovetail cutout, now here some two edges it comes, that we could not see. Bottom two edges it's coming, so those edges also we could not able to see over in the top view. Okay, those things we are going to construct over here. Select a line. So before that we are going to make a one line. Okay, this is for our reference. So already we have converted this one as a dotted line, that's what it comes over there. So again I'm going to select, now I'm going to change it as a continuous line. Okay, so now I'm going to draw a line from here, straight line. I'm going to stop from here to, what is the depth over it comes. Okay, from here to here. So this side we are going to make it as a up to this, it will become so much mm up to this end. Okay, so it is almost 100 mm. So same like here, so it will becomes in this manner. So that is the 64 mm distance. So select a line, 64 mm distance. Okay, then what is the difference from here? So from here to 15 mm length, and I'm going to close over here. And also this 16 mm distance, the inclined surfaces it comes. So select a line from here to 16 mm distance. I'm going to join over here, and from here to 16 mm distance, going to join over here. Okay, after joining this, so one of the portion, this area is completed. Then comes to select over the end. So already we viewed how the top view comes. According to that, I'm going to draw the this one. So the baseline I'm going to draw over here. So here compulsory you have to draw the projection lines. So this projection line thickness we have to maintain as a 0.13 mm. Same like here also we have to maintain as a 0.13 mm thickness. So this drawing lines we have to maintain the 0.5 mm thickness over in this solid edge. Then comes to here, select a line, exactly the rib is passing over mid of the component with the 12 mm dimensions. So go over here. So already I told you in the side view, sorry, front view, this inclined portion it will be going to project over towards to the vertical plane. It comes as a straight line, same like here as a this inclined portion, it comes as a straight line over here up to 70 mm distance. It has to be coming over from here. So from the mid, so it has 12 mm. So one side is the 6 mm and what is the dimension length? 70 mm length and 12 mm dimension, going to stop over here. Okay, so after stopped over here, that's it. We need to draw the visible edges. Then which are all the other things? This dovetail cutout. So the maximum length is the 30 mm, minimum length they have not given here, so that we have to make it in the other manner. So So from middle to 30 mm means from this side 15 mm. Going to make a straight line, and from here to again 15 mm. Delete this line. So I'm going to start with the from here itself 30. Enter. Going to make it over here. Okay. Now I'm going to check the dimensions from here to here 30. From this line to this line. So that is the problem. So here from here to here, what is the distance? That is the 16 mm. Okay, so delete. This line I'm going to delete. So first I'm going to make it as a 16 mm line. 1 6, enter. Control Z. Go to the offset. Distance 16 mm, single, this, enter. So it comes over here. Same like here, you can go and measure the distance from here to edge to this distance. Almost that is the 16 mm. So here somewhat it got wrong, so that's what that we rectified. So after this, so from this relation itself we can find where we are going to make the mistake. So then afterwards this straight lines are going to make it as a daughter lines. After creating the daughter lines, what happens? The next thing we are would have to check the bottom edges. So this edges, they given as a only the 60 degree angle, so that we could not able to make over here. Okay, so that we have to draw from the other views. So in the top view or front view also it's not possible, so that we can try with the side view. So now we are going to draw the right side view. So already I told you, right side view it comes in the left side of the front view. Okay, why we are going to choose the right side view means because the maximum area we can see over in the right side only, so that those view only we can select. Even if any of the diagram the left side view mostly can able to view, means those view only can able to draw the drawings. Okay, so go here and this one, the entire drawings we can select with help of move option. You can move over in the other side. Okay, now before drawing the side view, first we are going to make a 45 degree line over towards down. So 45 degree line means from 180 plus 45, 225. So to 225 degree line you can draw. Afterwards extend the line towards here and extend this one, extend to the next, and select use the trim option, trim it, and select a line from here to wherever it will be touches the 45 degree line, from there to make it as a straight vertical line. Okay, same like here also, this is the edge, I am going to make a straight line over here. Okay, so now same like all the edges we have to project from here to here. I am going to make it over towards the top. So sometimes you could not get me, so please trim it. Select a line over here. So in this line you can get the edge, you can project over here. So in the last, even the dotted line also you can project it. Okay, so then from here to this side. So from the dotted line again going to project. So from here as well as this line, and this is the one more edge. So there itself the rib end, it will be joints over here, so no issues. So select the trim option. This extra lines you can trim it. After trim these lines, okay, whatever things we have drawn, so those first we have to convert into the convert into the 0.13 mm line. Go over here, select all those things, 0.13 mm line. So this as well as this how to convert as a 0.13 mm line. Now we will come over here, see the drawings, and side view only these things you can see over here, as well as this inclined rib surface, and here this one and this one. Okay, those things you can see over there. Okay, so what is the length? 64 mm. Even you can check over here, this projection it will be ends, so this will be this projection, it intersect of this projection line. So from there to I am going to make a line over here, so we will check it over here. So I have not given any dimension, even it will becomes as a exact line if you exactly the end point. So somewhat it will be extended over here exactly in the end if you stop. So it is coming over here, sir. I am going to extend and use of trim. I am going to trim it, select trim option. So once again I can draw the line, it's not a issue. With 0.13 mm thickness. Okay, so what is the line? So exactly it comes as a 64 mm line. So after drawing the 64 mm line, the height is the 22 mm. So height is the 22 mm. So I'm going to make a box over here. Select a line. So from here to 22 mm. Enter from here. Join over here, those lines. Okay, now so in this line, so what happens, this one it will be coming over here exactly in the middle. So those projection lines I have not drawn. Why? Because of it will be creating trouble over with the continuous line as well as this one, so that I am going to stop. So from the mid of this line, so mid from here to what is the distance over here, already we have seen that is the 30 mm distance. Okay, so from here to 30 mm I am going to draw, sorry, 30 means 15 mm. 15 mm as well as the other side 15 mm. 1 5. So after drawn the 15 mm, now I'm going to make it as a the angle as what is the given, the angle is the 60 degree. So from ground to the angle is the 60 degree, so that what I'm going to do, so from here to I'm going to make a minus I think I'm going to give 60 degree over here. We'll check it. If anything goes wrong, we will change it. 60 degree in the opposite direction. So trim it. This area I'm going to check the angle between this and this. So it is a 60 degree angle. So same like in the this side also, from here to, so now it comes as a 60 degree means 90 plus 60. So from here to I think minus 60 will write, minus 60. So it comes over end and go to the trim, select a trim for the small extended line, and angle you can measure with help of angle between this as well as this. So that also 60 degree. Now after drawing this 60 degree, these lines I am going to project over towards the this one, that 45 degree line. So wherever it will be cuts, I am going to draw a straight line over here. Okay. So same like from here, I am going to make a straight line. After making the straight line, use of trim option, this lens I am going to trim, even this also I am going to trim as of now. Why? Because of this should be comes as a 0.13 mm line. Okay. So this two line change it as a dotted lines over here. Then this will be point dotted line, this also, sorry, this continuous line only, but projection is 0.13 mm, projection is 0.13 mm. Select a line from here to make a straight line. Okay, so like this way we have to draw those bottom edges of the total cutout. So after making this, the remaining portion we will draw. So the remaining portion, it is easy only. So the profile you can see, so straight line, this inclined edge, so you'll see from here the inclined edge, it will become as inclined edge only, but the inclined surfaces that comes as a straight, inclined edge only it will becomes as a inclined only. So that we have to make it go for here, select a line over here, from here to we're going to stop over here. Okay, then almost going to join this one here, this one approximately we will know that what is the dimension, so we are going to stop over here. Then we can check the dimension the distance between from here to here. So even here to this one, so almost it will be 16 mm only. It's correct. Even here also, this line to this line, the distance is 16 mm. So everything is correct. Then you can stop. Only thing is this rib we have to make over here. So the rib, where is the rib option? So this is the rib from here to, that means this edge, behind of this edge, this edge is coming over here. So we can start from this edge itself, height of 40 mm distance. Select a line exactly in the middle. So see over here, suppose you could not able to find, see from the front view. So from front view, that is the length is the 6 mm from the middle. So 6 and height is the 40. So this is the 40 mm. So even that projection will help you. Then 12 mm length. After that I'm going to join over here. So after joining this, that's almost the view get over. You can write it here as a with help of text. So front view or FV, and here TV, and here as a RSW, right side view, RSV, R S right side view. Okay, now if you want to give the dimension, definitely you have to give the dimension. So you can give the dimension over here. Okay, so any one view can give the dimension. Then go on, select the distance between from here. Select the distance between from here to here, 16 mm. So like that we have to give over here. So from here to here, so like that the dimension we can give over here. That's it. So once if you are given the dimension, you can save as the drawing as a this one, orthographic view, or component name orthographic, and I'm going to save over here. Then close it. So like this way we have to draw the orthographic views. So with that, the orthographic view get over.